Hi everyone, it's AC here from Harney Brothers Films.
Yep, and AJ as well. So we are going to do Warner Brothers after a little bit of demand. We did Disney DVDs, we did our entire Blu-ray collection, and now it's time for our Warner Brothers collection.
You beauty.
Movies, DVDs, and Blu-rays. Mainly DVDs, yeah. A couple of Blu-rays in there. So I'll just get started with the first one in no particular order. Batman Begins from 2005. We got The Best Years of Our Lives. Blade Runner from 1982. Casablanca from 1942. The Dark Knight from 2008. The Dark Knight Rises from 2012. Dial M for Murder. Goodfellas. The Green Mile from 1999. Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part 2. Heat from 1995. LA Confidential from 1996. The Matrix from 1999. North by Northwest. Shawshank Redemption from 1994. All right, AC.
There'll be lots of other films, and I'll be doing a lot of them, so it may take some time. So, anyway, let's get started. This is Rockstar. This came out back in 2003. Gods and...
Generals.
Generals, Gods and Generals. This is from 2002. Message in a Bottle. This came out in 1999.
I got the Police song stuck in my head now.
Great. That is a great song, everyone. And this is The Perfect Storm. Three Kings from, I'd say, 2001.
1999.
Yeah.
Somewhere in that ballpark.
Yeah, you're right, it was 1999.
Okay.
This is The Blind Side from 2010. Oh, actually, 2009.
Yep, 2009.
Yeah. Analyze This from 1999. The sequel was in 2002. Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. This is the 2005 remake. There was the original version back in 1971.
Crazy. Originally, we had Warner Brothers back here, over here, but we got Universal over here for a future video.
Yeah, and I'll tell you why, because I've bought a lot of Warner Brothers films in the last year. And yep. Recently, it was really getting to a point that it was running out of space. So yeah, and we're going to continue on. And this is Sit Tight. This is from 1931. Dancing Lady from 1933. It stars Clark Gable, Ted Healy, and the Stooges. And the Stooges are and the Stooges from that era were Moe, Larry, and Curly. A Day at the Races from 1937. King of the Underworld from 1939. City for Conquest from 1940. The Westerner from 1940. Yankee Doodle Dandy from 1942. This is The Big Street from 1942. Air Force from 1943. Mr. Skeffington from 1944. Now It's the Clock from 1945. Anchors Away from 1945. San Antonio 1945. My Wild Irish Rose from 1947. The Babe Ruth Story from 1948. Words and Music from 1948. Look for the Silver Lining from 1949. The Fountainhead from 1948, but it didn't come out till 1949 in theaters. But I think this movie was filmed in 1948. Okay, guys. Let's do... Love Is Better Than Ever from 1951. Above and Beyond from 1952. My Joe Young from 1949. My Liar from 1949. The Breaking Point from 1950. The Damned Don't Cry from 1950. The Next Voice You Hear is from 1950. Three Little Words from 1950. The Yellow Cab Man from 1950. The Narrow Margin from 1950, but it wasn't released until 1952, but it was filmed in 1950. It was delayed by almost 2 years. Lullaby of Broadway from 1950, but it was actually released in early 1951. Strangers on a Train from 1951. A Millionaire for Christie, 1951.
That was a terrible movie.
Yep, and another good movie, Cowboy Went That Way from 1951. Cowboy. I think most of y'all have heard of those films.
Yep, very obscure movies that he likes.
Yep, well done that.
Yep. Yes, you're right. Too right.
House of Wax, 1953. The Bandwagon, 1953. The Moonlighter, 1953. Calamity Jane, 1953. Escape from Fort Bravo, 1943. East of Eden from 1955, then from 1954, Many Rivers to Cross, 1955, Mr. Roberts, 1955, I'll Cry Tomorrow, 1955, The Bad Seed from 1956, The Helen Morgan Story from 1957, Top Secret Affair, 1957, Bombers B-52, 1957, All Mine to Give, 1957, The Sheepmen, 1958, Onion Head from 1958, It Started with a Kiss, 1959, No Time for Sergeants, 1958, stars Andy Griffith and Don Knotts, and this was their first film together, as Andy Griffith and Don Knotts starred on this great American comedy sitcom, The Andy Griffith Show, and they were on together for 5 years. Andy had the show for 8 years. Don Knotts left during the fifth season of it. So yeah, good movie. This is a really good movie, but if you're an Andy Griffith Show fan, and if you haven't seen this, I recommend y'all go watch it. You won't regret. It's pretty good, everybody. The FBI Story from 1959. This is Never So Few, 1959. This is Please Don't Eat the Daisies, 1960. The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn, 1960. This is a two-film collection. It's from the greatest classic films from TCM, which is a great movie app and channel to watch for people like me and people like older people, but I'm not very old yet. But big classic movie fans. But I'll tell you the movies now: Ocean's 11 from 1960 and Robin and the Seven Hoods from 1964. And these star the Rat Pack, Frank Sinatra, Dean Martin, Sammy Davis Jr. And if you're a big fan of those, please go watch it. I'll be greatly appreciated by that. Bachelor in Paradise, 1961. The Music Man from 1962. Ride the High Country, 1962. Critics' Choice from 1963. It stars Bob Hope and Lucille Ball.
If the critics had a choice in that, they wanted to watch the movie. Also, that's how bad it is. That's it.
Pretty good. If you're a big fan of Lucille Ball or Bob Hope, go watch it if you'd like. But please tell me if you've seen it. But if you haven't, please go watch it. But if you have, tell me how good or bad it really was. But anyways, this is The Wheeler Dealers from 1963. Four for Texas, 1963. The Prize from 1963. Cheyenne Autumn, 1964. Your Cheating Heart, 1964. Kisses for My President, 1964. Girl Happy, 1965. The Great Race, 1965. Marriage on the Rocks, 1965. The Glass Bomb Boat, 1966. Now from 1966. Mildred Pierce from 1945. This is Gang Game from 1971. All American Boy, 1973. The Swarm, 1978. Blazing Saddles, 1974. The Sackets, 1979. National Lampoon's Vacation, 1983. Gremlins from 1984. National Lampoon's European Vacation, 1985. National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation, 1989. Nothing but Trouble, 1991. Kongener from 1991. The Last Boy Scout, 1991. JFK, 1991. Innocent Blood, 1992. A Perfect World, 1993. Clint Eastwood also directs the movie. He stars in this film, teaming up with Kevin Costner. Maverick from 1994. It's a remake of the TV show Maverick from 1957-1962. It ran air for 5 seasons. And James Garner did not play Brett Maverick in the movie, but he played a different character. Mel Gibson plays the Maverick character, and he did a great job. Natural Born Killers from 1994. A Time to Kill, 1996. Ten Cup from 1996, My Fellow Americans 1996, Mad City 1997, U.S. Marshals 1998,
Network, Inception, Clockwork Orange, and then I have Ben-Hur.
The Majestic from 2001, Starsky and Hutch from 2004, The Big Bounce 2004, The Phantom of the Opera, this was 2004, A Must Love Dogs 2005, Rumor Has It from 2005, Kiss Kiss Bang Bang 2005, Firewall from 2006. All right, so.
And then we got one more.
You got one more.
Inherent Vice from 2014. And we got a lot of John Wayne films.
Yep, and most of his films were Warner Brothers.
Got a couple of these.
Yep.
I'll start off a little bit.
That'd be great,
man. We got first one, Without Reservations. I don't think I've even heard this one.
It wasn't that good, to be honest with you, but that's why I probably never heard of it. Even as a big John Wayne fan, it's pretty terrible, though.
Yep, okay.
Don't watch it.
We got Fort Apache, if I'm saying that right. I have no idea.
Well done, you're right.
Okay.
Well done, bro.
This one, I don't know if I'm going to say this one right either.
Well, I'll give you
a Eleni Uprising? Eleni Uprising, how you say
it? It's a leg...
I don't think either of us
say it. Say it whenever.
Someone correct us in the comments.
Please pronounce like you whenever you want.
Next up, Three Godfathers. She Wore a Yellow Ribbon. And then Trouble Along the Way.
Sea Chase from 1955. The Wings of Eagle 1957. Big Jim McLean 1952. And Rio Bravo, 1959. And this is not a John Wayne movie. And this is, actually stars Edward G. Robinson. But this is Illegal from 1955. Great drama film. It's a murderer film. So if you're a big fan of Edward G. Robinson, go watch it, please. That'll be really great. And this was probably second or third favorite Edward G. Robinson film. Which, of course, my favorite would have to be Done with Humanity, which is a great film for everybody to watch.
Cahill, U.S. Marshal. The Train Robbers. The Cowboys. Sounds like an interesting movie, isn't it?
Pretty good, guys.
Okay.
Pretty good.
Your generic John Wayne movie.
Yeah.
For better or for worse. For worse for me, some people might like it for better.
Alright, so everybody, my turn.
Everybody, we did those already.
flip. This is a four film collection of old John Wayne war stuff or a few of them, and I'm just naming some now. They were Expendable 1945, Operation Pacific 1951, and there is also Flying Leathernecks from 1951, Back to Baton in 1945. And this is another four-film John Wayne collection. This is even better than the one I just did. This is probably the good films that I first grew up watching when I started becoming a big John Wayne fan. The Shooters from 1976, Sons of K. Elder 1965, The Searchers 1956, How the West Was Won 1962, The Green Berets 1968.
Green Berets.
And those are all the John Wayne Warner Brothers films, but this is a memorable franchise from the late 80s and early 90s.
Starts off decent and goes downhill. Train wreck.
It's total opposite.
There's supposed to be a fifth one too. I'm not really.
Comes out next year sometime, I hope.
Yeah, I don't know if the strike, if that's gonna.
Probably be 2 years from now, hopefully.
We'll see. Probably 2025 then. We'll see, but you revealed it.
All right, everybody. This is all four Lethal Weapon films. Stars Mel Gibson and Danny Glover. Later on, Joe Pesci, Chris Rock, Rean Russo. Darling Love was there for all four of them, as well as Danny and Mel. Mm-hmm. So yeah, the first one came out in 1987. Second one came out in 1989. The third one came out in 1992, and the fourth one came out in 1998. And all of these films were directed by Richard Donner, who was a great director back in those days.
Yep, rest in peace.
He sadly passed away a couple of years ago, and he will not direct Lethal Weapon 5. Mel Gibson is going to take over the directing duties while still starring as his character in the film.
Yep. We'll see if it even gets released. I won't be surprised if it gets canceled.
All right. These are the Western selection of TCM. And as half good films, half one so-so and one not so good. All right. Chisholm from 1970. Pat Garrett and Billy the Kid, 1973. Starring Bob Dylan and Chris Crawfordson. The Stalking Moon, starring Gregory Peck. I believe it was in the 60s sometime, maybe late 60s. And Always Says But Ride the High Country. If you're a big Western fan, go check these films out. Maybe not The Stalking Moon, but check whatever you want out.
Haven't seen any of them. All right, so we got two more compilations, and that will be it. We got, first of all, Greatest Classic Films. One of these is not like the others. Casablanca is the only one I would even consider close to being one of the greatest classic films of all time. The other ones, while not bad, are not really that great either. We got Mrs. Miniver. We got An American in Paris. And then we got Gigi or Gigi.
It's Gigi, man.
Gigi. I've seen Gigi, but I forgot what it was about. So this is the greatest classic films by TCM. We got maybe one more. Let's see. We got the greatest classic film. This is more.
I think the first one was
okay. Best Picture winners. Okay, this makes more sense. So, correction. Best Picture winners. Yep, Casablanca by far the best. This one is Broadway musicals. I have not seen any of these.
And I bought those in 2016 at Target and at the local Target in Cape Girardeau. It's about an hour and a half from us, but some of these were good, and then I think there was one that was not so good.
Yep. You got Annie Get Your Gun, Showboat, Kiss Me Kate, and Seven Brides for Seven Brothers.
And all of those are Howard Keel films as well.
These don't look that good, but not my cup of tea, but maybe you like
them. And you Get Your Guns, my one of my favorite musicals, apart from The Music Man and the Mary Poppins.
Is that everything? You got a couple more?
No. Well, yeah, it's every dog. That's it right now.
All right. So, thank you guys for enjoying this video. If you stayed, if not, then you'll pay for it. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. That was a terrible joke. But I just want to say, let us know, what should we do next on here? What video do you want us to do? The Honey Brothers. We have some ideas, but we want to hear your
ideas too. Lots of ideas, everybody. And you're welcome to help us out along this journey, everyone.
Yep, lots of ideas. But we want to hear your ideas. What do you want us to do? It could be anything movie related. Anything. We're Honey Brothers Films. But I just want to say, I'll let you do the outro.
Thank you, everyone, for watching our video. And keep going, growing. And keep on wiggling. See you guys.